Today we are going to play Gondor against Hard Army Mordor on the beautiful map Southern Ithilien, and this is a ranger map, and for that reason we are not allowed to recruit any other hero but Faramir and to recruit any other units but the rangers from the archer range level 2. And of course we are also not allowed to summon the army of the dead, the eagles, the Rohirrim, and also not the elves. And yeah, let's start with a blacksmith and a farm inside our base and use the soldiers to grab those settlements, and then we're gonna sacrifice them right after that. As we are not allowed to fight with them. Eye of Sauron is watching us, but it's fine. And also, we won't be recruiting Peregrine Took. Sorry for that, you full of a Took. It was so funny, you know, in the films when Gandalf was bashing him all the time. Like, Gandalf clearly didn't like Peregrine Took, guys. He was kinda okay with Merry. He was kind of okay with Sam, and he was kind of in love with Frodo Baggins, even though I believe that Samwise Gamgee is the best hobbit by far in the entire film. But he didn't like Peregrine too, for whatever reason. I cannot understand that. So basically, we are going to save for Faramir at some point, because Faramir is a ranger hero, just like in the films Lord of the Rings and the Two Towers. As they were fighting against the Mumakils, this scene was quite underrated. I was actually falling in love with the rangers, with their look, you know, their design. I liked it a lot. So we're not gonna fight, we're gonna just dance around to Rosie and let them kill us. I don't wanna kill any of these orcs with the soldiers though. Build one more farm inside the base. And I believe then we slowly but surely going to save for Faramir. And give him the chance to finally show his quality. Dance around to Rosie, soldiers. Forward! Okay. So basically Faramir, then we are going to fill up the base with like resource buildings, farms and blacksmiths only, and then we are going to build the archer range, but since we need to recruit 4 archers before the archer range hits level 2, we will send them right into the Mordor base, the archers, so we won't fight with them. We need to feed them though, because we have only 200 command points. I don't want to waste my command points on those Gondor archers. Here's the tower, let's run into the tower. So we have not killed any of these units, by the way. The golem is, you know, look at the golem, guys. Look at this beautiful picture. This guy is handsome, you know what I'm saying? Like, he's having a good and easy time on the girls. Trust me on that one. So now, slowly but surely, saving up for Faramir. He costs 1200. And Faramir and Boromir, they are both entering the battlefield by being rank 3. And Faramir, once he's level 5, he will be unlocking his leadership, which is an armor leadership for a nearby allied unit. And also fear resistant. And yeah, without Boromir, Gondor will lack of damage leadership. And damage leadership is actually quite needed in order to burst down the trolls, the Mumakils, and especially the catapults later on. But I like this idea of these challenges, you know, because it's Southern Ithilien, the ranger map. Let's build one more blacksmith. Now we can use Faramir to eventually creep the goblin lair around this side. And also, it's been a really long time since I played this map last time. I believe the last time I played this map, guys, was like before they shut down the servers. And I was kind of playing quick match games, you know, in a one-on-one situation. And then I was playing this map a couple of times. This map is quite underrated. So you have a camp on each side, top right and bottom left side. That is also a settlement I was not... I forgot about that, to be honest with you guys, at the bottom left side. But it's fine. And a couple of these settlements are protected by the goblin lair, as you can see and tell. The forbidden pool, by the way. Just like in the films. Oh, we gotta close the gate though. Even though Gondor Citadel is able to shoot, but still. Let's not risk the biscuit. He has like level 3 orcs. I'm assuming he was able to creep the goblin lair right here. Keep up the attack. Alright, Faramir, the captain of Gondor. The music in the background, always giving goosebumps. So one more blacksmith is needed, and then we are finally able to go for a transition into the archer range. And again, 4 archers are required. Looks like this orcs are gonna try to kill our Faramir, but... that's not gonna be the case. And of course, we are not allowed to get mounted with Faramir, because Faramir is a hero who can be a ranger when he is on foot, and also a Gondor knight when he is on horse. So now we can kill, and we can always peel back. So let's open a Posan gate. In the worst case scenario, we can enter Gondor, and let's pick up the heal from the spellbook. Look how much damage they are dealing to us. Holy guacamole. Okay, peel back. Faramir, don't die. I don't want to waste my heal yet, you know what I'm saying? And look at the damage from orc archers though. But if you don't know, guys, rangers and also Faramir, when they're around the trees, they are getting stealth and invisible. So even with the rangers, you can, you know, toggle off the auto attack. So this way they won't automatically attack a target when the target is nearby. And this way you can also become invisible for a longer duration. And few of you guys maybe know that, but rangers, when they are in the melee range, they are also able to knock down the target. I will show you guys later on what I'm talking about. So of course we gotta chill a bit. We need to play a bit safe because we have no units on the field for now. And this is kind of off meta build because normally Gondo likes to get Gondo knights on the field and then save up for Gandalf and get the power points from the spellbook unlocked for Gandalf the White. And then you have the most efficient and the strongest hero on the field from the BFME1. But Gandalf unfortunately is not allowed in this 1v1 situation. Alright, so 4. Let's also buy Banner because that's the only upgrade besides Fire Arrow you can actually purchase on your Rangers. They are not allowed to have Forge Blades or the armor upgrade. Indeed, that's the only Archer Battalion who is not able to purchase heavy armor. I like to call them glass cannons because that's what they are. They are all about dealing damage, you know. We will lose these farms, but it's fine. I'm not worried about that. We will be able to reclaim them later on once we have Rangers on the field. And let's actually send them right into the base from Mordor, shall we? Again, no fighting, just sacrificing. The Forbidden Pool. Oh, he was actually able to capture this mill. Oh, that's bad. This Mordor will have no money problems whatsoever. He might be even able to buy this camp very soon. But I want to show you guys the Forbidden Pool. You see that? Just like in the films. Looks amazing. And again, for a game which is like made in the early 20s, you know, this game's graphics are not looking that bad, trust me on that one. So it's not bad at all. Faramir, you can maybe kill some units left and right and get level 5 as soon as possible. Because that's the only way we can get leadership for the Rangers. Damage is no problemo, but we will be outnumbered as you can see. And look how many orcs he has on the field, that's crazy. Archer Battalion standing by. But now we have finally Archer range level 2, that's dope. And now it is time to first of all buy the Fire Arrow upgrade and then recruit bunch of Rangers. They are only allowed to have 10 of them because they cost 20 command points each and we have only 200 available command points. Let's peel back with Faramir. Actually killing those orcs when you think about that is kind of bad because that's going to open like a command point for the Mordor faction and he will be going for a transition into the troll cage, into the catapults. So it's actually a bad thing to kill them, to be honest with you. But I want to get my Faramir level 5 ASAP. And look how many orcs he has around the wall. That's crazy. But Gondor has a really strong durability in terms of defense, you know. And for that reason, until he will have siege weapons on the field, there is no need of being worried. And you are also able to use the skirmish formation, which is going to make them deal a bit more damage. But you also lose 50% armor, which is something... Don't do that unless you are... Unless you know that you won't take any damage in return, or when you have Faramir leadership. Then you can do that also, because Faramir will give you 50% increased armor leadership. So even with the skirmish formation, they will have equally as much armor. But again, Rangers, they are glass cannons. They are all about dealing damage. They are not meant to tank any damage. They are also very vulnerable against trample damage, you know? But if you don't know, guys, Rangers are the best archers in the entire game by far. In terms of damage output, at least. And when you put them in an outpost, for example, like you buy the outpost with the 3 spots, you know, and then you place the ranger inside the outpost with a statue behind, holy guacamole, they are going to simply hit like a truck. Look at the looks, guys. They are looking amazing, in my opinion. You see the skin? Like, that was also the look from Aragorn. He was also one of them. And Aragorn, of course, is not existing in the Gondor faction in Battle for Middle-earth 1. Holy moly. How are we able now to leave the base, dude? So I believe what we gotta do, hold on a second, let's buy upgrades first, let's wait for the second one, let's open another Poseidon gate right here, and then we're gonna demolish the blacksmith and build a well here just for the sustain. And if you are wondering why I'm not doing that right now, it's simple, because I want to have the full value of the steel bonus for 40% discount on my upgrades. Okay, let's not use the skirmish formation yet. So now we have a bunch of rangers. Now let's demolish this, build a well for the sustain, and let's go out and fight a little bit. Again, we are not allowed to pick any power points besides the Elven Wood and the Heal. Maybe Cloudbreak also, but let's try to win without that. Okay, now we gotta kill some orcs. Let's hunt some orcs. Where is Faramir at? Faramir is here, okay. Don't let them approach. Like, he has so many archers on the field too. Holy moly. Faramir is getting some levels, so that's dope. Eye of Sauron is being used. We have now one power point collected. Let's pick up the Elven Wood and use it immediately. Right off the bat. Please? Please? Oh, that was a horrible Elven Wood. We are losing a lot of archers, so. But Faramir is level 5 now. That's dope. Now we have a bit more durability. Let's try to not lose a full battalion, shall we? Let's peel back with the one who is damaged. Go inside the jeans. Faramir can tank the damage for a little bit. I'm not worried about Faramir. Faramir is a hero who is, of course, way way tankier. And those rangers. So again, killing those units may be not the best idea in the world, to be honest. Because we will just give him more command points he can work with to recruit some stronger creatures like the trolls. But I'm not worried about trolls. I'm worried actually about the catapults. Because they are kind of very tough to deal with. Okay, let's heal up a bit. And money is a problem because we have not a single outside settlement. We have only the resource buildings inside our castle. And if you don't know, Gondor has 9 spots in the castle, you know, while Rohan has only 7 and Isengard and Mordor have only 8. So long story short, with Gondor in long terms, you will get more money from your castle because you have one more spot at least. If not 2 more spots if you are facing against Rohan. Okay, now we have a lot of rangers. Holy moly, let's get actually more of them. Look at the damage, dude. It reminds me of the campaign mission, you know? Oh, look, Gollum. Gollum was running it down. You know the campaign mission, guys, when you had set up an ambush, you know? When the Mumakils are arriving and you were forced to kill the Mumakils. That's also one of my favorite missions in the good campaign of Battle for Middle-earth 1. Come, Rangers. We need one more, then we are gonna be command points capped. We cannot upgrade them yet because we have not the money for that. But it's okay, we will be recovering now a couple of these farms. And then, oh, he was already able to buy the camp. We also see Haradrims. That's dope. Just like in the films, you know? I really hope that he's gonna also get some Mumakils on the field. But this is something they rarely do. The Hard Army from Mordor likes to get some trolls or catapults. But not... Look, that's what I'm talking about. You see, the siege works. So we gotta kill it ASAP. Let's give them fire to increase the DPS. And Faramir, once he's level 7, will unlock the Captain of Gondor for giving even more experience to the Rangers. Alright, let's capture this farm. Alright, now let's see our damage power. We gotta kill this. We gotta kill this. We gotta kill this catapult the second it's arriving. Even with Fire Arrow, without the damage leadership, as you can see and tell, our damage output is not the greatest. We need still a lot of time to actually burst down the siege works. And even one catapult, you see how strong it is? And it's able to one-shot our units just like that. That is a Nazgul. Let's kill him. Oh, we took so much damage with the one unit. Holy moly. Faramir's warning arrow is also able to damage him big time, but I think it's not needed, right? Right? It's not needed. Okay. Let's kill these units first, and then we're gonna save up for 2,000 to be able to buy this camp at the bottom left side. So for now, we are doing a good job. Elven Wood is almost available, but the only problem we have is the money. And let's use the Elven Wood right off the bat for even more armor leadership. And let's capture this settlement at the bottom left side. We can give them also a banner. More orcs are coming all the time from everywhere, literally. Please kill those units already, man. We need a little bit more money, though. And for that reason, capturing... Oh, he has even fire now on his archers. But do you see that? So many... you know, of these beautiful rangers. I like that. Okay, we have now the money, which is dope. It's the enemy! Take cover, man! It's the enemy. Take cover, man. Be alert, rangers. Now we can build also like a statue and a well for more leadership in terms of damage and a well for a sustain. Then we can just simply put them all inside and take a selfie, you know what I'm saying? Because I wanna put that like in my documentary of Battle for Middle-earth. Like, I've never seen this many rangers on the field besides in the campaign mission, you know? And I never played like that in Gondor. I normally like those mobile units like Gondor Knights, you know, like Gandalf, who can be fast, who can ride from one side to the other side pretty much all the time. Faramir, the captain of Gondor. I know Sauron is watching us. Alright, so we will recover over time. And let's build some more blacksmith just to make sure that we have enough money. We can also build some towers to... Gondor camp is the weakest camp. It's kind of tricky though. What is happening here? Oh, we are getting attacked. We gotta build a tower. That's what Mordor is always doing. He's using one of the Nazgûs to always keep attacking your citadel, which is kind of annoying, to be honest with you. We have 5 power points collected, but we cannot use them. So we're not gonna use any of the power points. And what I would love to do is I wanna actually buy this camp first at the top right side. So let's make a let's leave a couple of these inside the base, inside the camp. I mean. And then again, we can put them around the trees. This way they can get invisible. You see, halt fire. This is going to make them, like, left click to not fire automatically. So they won't attack. And you see the camouflage. They are now invisible. Oh, he's coming now from the other side. But it's okay. Let's not lose the unit. Oh, there comes an Nazgul. We gotta burst him. Oh my goodness. He's still able to one-shot us. We need to replace the Titan. Let's use heal. We should be able to win this fight, right? Hopefully, yes. Okay. Power points are rising. Now we have Captain of Gondor from Faramir. Alright. Now we have also some levels on our rangers. Let's capture this Mills. He might attack us, but that's fine. He doesn't know what we know. We have defense here, my friend. Ambush time. In our high... What is... Oh, they are actually... I sent them to this spot. They are entering the castle. They are smart. You know what I'm saying? The pathing of BFME 1 is actually not bad. Like, when it comes to pathing, when you, for example, want your units to go to one side of the map, they are not always the smartest when it comes to choose the right path. You know what I'm saying? That's why I like to set waypoints like that. With Alt and then right-click, you can set waypoints. And this way, you can control the pathing of your units. Which might actually be quite efficient when you want to increase your APM in the game. Action per minute. Just to be more efficient with your time, you know? Time is the key to victory in RTS games. You need to be just fast. Alright. Oh, he was also buying this camp. Yeah, you see? That's what I'm saying. He was also building a siege works there. We gotta kill the siege works ASAP before he will be able to recruit more and more catapults all the time. And this base is in a safe spot. One of them is level 3 now. Remember, statue is also giving us 100% increased combat experience. This means our units are going to be able to level up twice as quickly. Power points are rising. I would love to get Gandalf, but rules are rules, you know? And this is a challenge for one of you guys meet this challenge in the most recent video. Remember, we were also playing Mordor with orcs only. We were also playing Rohan with elves only. Now, oh my goodness, the catapult shot. Now we are playing Gondor with rangers only. And next time we will be playing, English is hard, Isengard with berserkers only. Like, you know, the one with the torches? And that's gonna be our plan. We're gonna recruit full command points from the Urukhet level to the berserkers. And we're gonna lit up the torches. And then we are going to celebrate, you know what I'm saying? That's gonna be for the next video, boys. In order to not miss this, please make sure to leave a like on this video and also subscribe for more content like this in the future. This actually quite helps me a lot, and I wanna say thank you in advance, guys. Alright, let's kill this mill right after it's already level 3. We are recovering the map a little bit. Gollum is revived. What are you killing? Why are you killing our rangers like that? We lost actually a lot of rangers. He's once again trying to kill our citadel, so we gotta build one more tower. Just to make sure that this Nazgul is not gonna be able to successfully destroy our citadel all the time. And also, archer range level 3 is able to shoot. And for that reason, the Nazgul go back to the shadow. Let's build farms. Farms are cheaper and also are able to level up a bit faster. So what I'm trying to say with that is, watch now. You see, we were building the farm at the same time as we were building the blacksmith. And the farm is now level 3 for a long time, and the blacksmith is still level 2. Indeed, the blacksmith, in order to hit level 3 from level 2, needs like ages. You need to invest like 25 to 30 minutes to get your blacksmith to level 3, which is something what I don't understand. But it is how it is. Old game, old mechanics. It's fine though. So let's use heal right off the bat, and we can also reuse the Captain of Gondor from Faramir to give them even more experience. Boom, now a couple of them are level 4. I don't see anyone level 5 just yet, but it's a matter of time, and they will be again. Level advantage in battle for Middle-earth 1 is massive. More levels means more damage. Now let's move on to our opponent's castle, shall we? Oh my goodness, so many rangers everywhere, literally. We have also a couple of them protecting the camp. But that was the playstyle of me in the campaign, you know? I didn't want to rush the campaign. You know the speedrunners, guys, they are trying to win the campaign as soon as possible, like in a very short duration. And I don't like that. I want to enjoy the campaign. That's why I was always making sure to destroy every single settlement first before I actually went for the victory. You know what I'm saying? I want to make sure that we are under control from every single camp, every single outpost, every single settlement before we go for the final push. That's what I enjoy when I play against AI. Also in skirmish, just like in the campaign, you know? I want to enjoy. That's why. I mean, like, nobody should be playing these games now, you know, nowadays, like, really competitively. For me, it's about enjoyment, about the fun factor, you know? And again, I was playing these games when I was, like, 12 years old. Now I'm 21 years old. And playing those games takes me back, you know what I'm saying? To the good old times in which we were coming home from the school, trying to beat some AIs, like having struggle against one, then we actually try to improve to play against 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. On every single map, I was trying to beat the AI. It was like a challenge for me, which I was also enjoying quite a lot. And now with 31 years, like almost 20 years after, I'm still enjoying it, you know what I'm saying? Some things never change. Look, he has a great defense. We can also push now from the other side. Let's get him fire arrows. Alright, the damage output, you can see that's what I'm talking about. Even though we have so many ranges on the field, the damage output is still not the greatest because we lack of damage leadership. And for that reason, Boromir is the best hero when you want to go for like infantry heavy army, like rangers, soldiers, tower guards. You want to make sure that you have Boromir level 4. This way you have like 60% increased damage leadership. Oh, call the horde. Now orcs are gonna join every single second. You see that? They are killing them. More of them are coming all the time. Like there is no more build time, by the way. They will just spawn automatically after, every couple of seconds. Let's kill this. Let's peel back, rangers. You have 17 power points collected, but who needs power points in 2021, right? Let's use heal. Boom, there we go. Keep up the pressure, kill units only. We are also on the Elven Wood, which grants us 40% increased armor. With Faramir's leadership, 50%. We have now 90% increased armor, so we are quite tanky. Let's use Captain of Gondor once again. My friends. And I believe, guys, let me know in the comment section down below. Do you think that Faramir was able to show his quality in this game? He didn't die once. He was actually sporting the Rangers big time. And you know what would be awesome? In the film, you know, in The Return of the King, when Gondor was defending Minas Tirith, right, with the archers, I was missing the rangers. I wanted to see some rangers coming and fighting against Mordor, you know? Because in the Two Towers one, we have seen rangers crushing the Mumakils. Like, they killed like 5-6 Mumakils in like literally 10 seconds. So imagine if you would have like some rangers, you know, defending Minas Tirith. But they were missing. Did they all got killed? Where were they, actually? Alright. Slowly but surely, working our way up to the victory. We have pretty much every single settlement under our control. So Mordor has like no settlements at all, beside the castle, of course, at the bottom right side. Power points are rising to the sky. We killed the Nazgul, that's dope. And unfortunately for us, he was never getting any Mumak kills on the field. But he was at least recruiting some Haradrim warriors. I'm down for that. Even though I would love to, you know, face against some Mumakils, but it's okay, it's okay. Not the end of the world. Rangers, move on. Level 2 rangers. We will protect these lands. Captain of Gondor is like quite long cooldown. You see how squishy they are, guys? You see how fast they are dying even though they are level 4? The reason for that is because they have no heavy armor. But the attack speed though, like a machine gun, you know, pew 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 pew. Having the highest attack speed in the entire game. Even faster than Legolas. Look at this. This is looking dope. I like that. The forces of evil, as Gondor, as Gandalf would like to say, are going to be defeated. very soon. If you guys enjoy this kind of videos, guys, please let me know in the comment section down below what challenge would you be up for the next video. Again, next video is kind of set. I would love to play Isengard with Berserkers only. I've never done that before. And again, the reason why I'm playing 1v1s, in this case, I wanted to see like the Southern Italian. Also was like a challenge from you guys in the comment section down below. But we can always go for like a bigger challenge, like 1v2, 1v3, 1v4. And the Mordor one we did like a couple of days ago, in which we were fighting against Isengard on the map Westwold with orcs only. I believe that's kind of impossible. It's like definitely impossible to win as Mordor with orcs against 7 Hearth armies. That's literally not possible. Trust me on that one. But we might try like a 1v2 situation or 1v3 situation just to test the waters. You know, what is possible, what is impossible. Thank you guys so much for watching. I will see you next time. Until then, keep hitting like a truck. And as always, stay beyond standards. Peace out.